The trailer, loaded with heavy cargo, almost snapped in half. For hours, this crash tied up La Vista traffic as workers cleaned up. But it wasn't the load that did this truck in. Good evening. I'm Rob McCartney.
And I'm Brandi Peterson. The damaged truck was a startling enough sight, and it only tells half the story. KETV News Watch 7's Todd Andrews is live on South 60th Street, where things really began. Todd?
Oh, Brandi, here is the bridge behind me, which the semi-truck hit earlier today. That's the Burlington Railroad Bridge at 5800 South 60th Street, actually almost 2 miles from where the truck nearly broke in half. Apparently, a detour on Harrison caused the driver of the truck to reroute, and that started what he calls now a very bad day. A semi-trailer with a broken back blocking eastbound Harrison Street most of Wednesday morning. Inside,
43,000 pounds of pure sugar headed for Skinner Bakery.
The load never made it to its destination, but the story didn't actually start here. It began here on 60th Street north of Harrison.
Well, I heard a big kerbang and I walked outside, and there was that truck sitting there.
Fresh scrapes show where the truck ripped its roof loose on the Burlington Railroad Bridge. Signs clearly mark the clearance height.
But it's obviously not specified for a trailer this high.
The driver, 26-year-old Jerome Horst out of Cantrell, Iowa, had never driven this route before, and he continued on. At 81st and Harrison, he decided to turn around, and that's when the trailer snapped. While La Vista authorities offloaded the cargo, Burlington inspectors were going over the bridge, deciding the damage was more cosmetic than structural. The railroad says this bridge has been hit many times before, something longtime residents of the area confirm.
The bridge is a 13-6, so sometimes things they make, sometimes they don't.
A little history for you. The bridge was actually built in 1904, and it's been through a lot in 105 years, but apparently it's quite tough. Burlington held up trains for about an hour today, then reopened the line after declaring the bridge safe, Brandi.
All right. Todd Andrews reporting live. Thank you, Todd.